So we wanted to talk about more about evolution, particularly the evolution of human beings and the evolution of our time here on Earth, or the evolution of the religions of the world, the evolution of the religious condition inside of mankind, inside of the human individual. And to do this, the first thing that especially people who are not trained in evolutionary anthropology or in evolutionary theory, I'm going to suggest that the best way to view evolution is as a system of phylogenous matrices. Now, for the educated, they're going to be like, "What the hell?" And for the uneducated, you're also going to be like, "What did he say?" And so let's do it differently. Look at it as the same way they represent compound chemical particles, molecules, and things in chemistry. You have a web. At every juncture along the way, there are all these little bodies, little fields, little spherical representations which denote a discrete, actual separate thing. And then you have connections between them, lines that go from each ball to each other ball, and they create a little like a three-dimensional web, like a three-dimensional grid. That's called a map. That's a phylogeny. It's also a matrix. It's a web, and it is the way to understand and represent pretty much everything that's complex and takes that form. But once you understand that form and you understand those patterns, then those things that used to be complex start to become easier to understand. One of the ways that we can eventually understand religion is by taking everything about religion that we've ever seen in the world and building one of these phylogenous matrices of it. And it will represent a web, but it also represents something sort of like a tree. In the very, very, very beginning, before men, there was just this raw sense of being, this raw consciousness that didn't question anything and just was, much as we assume the nature of animals to be. But eventually, humankind get to the point where they can really start to play with that reality and challenge it and reshape it according to their desires. How did they get to that? How did human beings get to that point? That's a critical question, not only in how did we get where we're at now, but where are we going to go from here and how are we going to get there? How did human beings create humanity out of nothing? Well, in the beginning, humans only had a critical relationship with the environment. They only had a critical relationship with the animals, with the plants, with the habitat that they shared. So this is the time that we now call animist. It looks pretty much the same way all over the whole world. Humans are at play in the field of the world, which is a responsive cellular unit that, has intelligence and needs to be properly stimulated to be successfully exploited for resources. If you overstimulate the environment, she gives out. If you understimulate the environment, she doesn't produce what you want. And so men become animists. The very beginning of religion is the synthesis of the natural environment and its spiritual components and the human psyche and spiritual experience. And you get the first priests who are shamans, who are guys and girls, and mostly just freaking psychos who they do everything for everyone in terms of how they figure out, what in the world is safe, what's not, and how do you relate to it? Now, as these guys take power and start to become more influential, they create things like politics and education and science, and they break from the original entrance into the spirit, which is the entire point of animistic, you know, worldview, so that you can be one with the spiritual nature of the universe around you. They create an institutionalized paradigm, a church, a system of do-nots, and they exploit people and they abuse them and they hurt everyone. And at the same time, the continuing stream of animism is never lost. The mystical perspective is never lost. The real trailblazers, the people who develop the real shifts in religion, they're never lost. You can separate them from the psychos, and that's part of being effective in your judgment and your understanding of religious evolution.